Stockwood, and it's a mess right now. Reverend Hugh, that's Brother Quincy Poe, just ain't the same. See, what happened here a couple years ago, there was an accident. The town's not got past it. See, Reverend Hugh thinks it's his fault. Little Rosalie passed away. Shh, we don't talk about it much, but it was tragic. Lord knows it wasn't his fault little Rosalie passed away. But you see, things here just ain't the same. Oh, here's the pastor and his kids now. His daughter Sammy, she took the loss of her friend Rosalie the hardest. I'm worried about him. About them all in stock with this Christmas.
Dad, you think your brother will like those shoes that we bought him?
Yeah.
What about you, Sam?
Why, Merry Christmas, Miss Marjorie.
Merry Christmas, Pastor, children.
I'm as red as rain, Daddy. Red as rain. School is out for Christmas.
Now, son, sometimes right is just a matter of perspective. Oh, here, take this bag and run on in the house. Your mother's got supper cooking. Sammy, wait just a minute. We need to talk. Honey, I've noticed you've been being withdrawn lately.
Me? Withdrawn? Daddy, you ain't been exactly Mr. Personality for months, and you know it.
Now, Sammy, this conversation isn't about me. It's about you, dear.
Always putting it off on me? Or someone else? What about you, Daddy? When's the conversation gonna be about you? Do something. It was my fault she came to church in the first place.
Well, I'm glad my youngins got good raisins.
Yes, Miss Old Fogey, your youngins are grown.
Uh-huh, preacher, but their youngins are raised right, too. They'll be here for Christmas. You'll see then. My grandchildren are good.
Yes, ma'am, you really blessed.
Uh-huh, preacher. You gotta control your own before you can have peace about advising others. Now, tell your wife she promised me a quilt patch. Gotta have my quilt done for Christmas.
Excuse me?
I need some fabric. Just tell her.
I hear you, Miss O'Fogey. I'll get it to you. Dinner's on the table, Q.
Okay, dear.
Look, Hugh, it's almost Christmas. We've got to get past all this. It's causing problems, not just in our family, but in everyone's family. See, people at church were going through the motions. We all love that little girl. She was a Christian. But we've got to move on. It's been a full year.
I'll be in a minute, dear.
Hag, Stu, get on the house.
I'll go get him.
Okay.
Pastor, get in the house quick. Cecil Poole's a coming.
I see.
No, you don't. You gotta get in the house. He's got an in for you, Pastor. He blames you and the church, you know.
Now, Raymond, you know that the church means you too.
Oh, he ain't got nothing to live for, Pastor. He ain't been right since last year. I think he's touched in the head.
Now, Raymond, we can't see what's inside a man's heart.
He's got a black heart now, Pastor. No disrespect. Now, I'd stay. I'd get your back. But I gotta go to the store. I gotta get some before it closes.
Merry Christmas, Raymond.
Hey!
Mr. Poole.
I guess you're going to enjoy Christmas with your family.
Mr. Poole, I...
You go on, preacher, while you can. All you people at your church, you go on.
Mr. Poole, I...
Don't you say a word to me. Don't try to make it up. You people make me sick. You take up a love offering and send me a check. How much you think will do it?
Now, Mr. Poole, we loved her too.
This Christmas season. Boys, this year Earl, he's got a quiet, but he's brave fun to have around.
Right around the corner there. Cool. Unbelievable. right place at the right time.
Awesome! A new neighborhood is awesome, right? Can't you dig it? Can't you just feel the love in the air? I can just smell the love. Or at least I think that's love I smell. Cool beans, Eugene! What a gas, Daddy-O! Give me some skin, Heavenly!
Okay.
Now, Heavenly, what are you thinking? Look down there. That's our new pad, and there's a church. And I bet there's going to be a Christmas play and Christmas music in a few nights. Can't you just dig it?
Groovy, just groovy. We came all this way. Groovy.
Don't flip your wing, Heaven. This is far out.
Hey.
Look at the dog. Gnarly.
It's far out, all right, away from my friends and family. I don't know about this mission, this new trip. It's a bummer.
She's spazzing, Daddy-O.
Hang loose, dude. This is a whole new scene for Heavenly.
Let me get this straight. We just have to get the job done here, and we can go home.
Here to spread a little peace and love. That's our mission. Right, Daddy-O?
Yeah. You people need to move along. We're trying to enjoy our evening in here.
Oh, hey, we're the Shermans. I'm Bobby Sherman. This is my wife, Cher. My daughter, Heaven Lee. And my son, Blue. Out of sight!
Yes, get out of sight, thank you.
Oh, we have the new pad down the street. Not quite as nice as your place. It's really bad. And these flowers grow in the winter, that is really bad, Mama.
Bad? What's bad?
I mean solid. Far out.
Solid? Far out? What country are y'all from? Speak English.
Copacetic, Mama.
Copa what? Hey, you were some kind of weirdos.
Hey, ma'am, don't bug out.
Bugs, and my flowers where?
Hang loose, Miss Ma'am. We're gonna split. Peace out.
Huh? Split what? A piece of what? Help me.
We're here to help you with your Christmas project.
Yes. The Christmas project. It says the first person that we meet on the street is going to be our contact.
My quilt project?
Oh, yes. Great name. Quilt project. We can help with the quilt project.
I'm tired of this. Just give me some patchwork quilt pieces from everybody. Now move along.
Well, as you've gathered, Cecil Poole is still real bitter to the church folks about what happened to Rosaline. But in spite of it all, Reverend Hugh seems to be thinking about the real meaning of Christmas. Miss Flo here, she thinks she finally has help on a quilt project. She's gone on about for a year now. Nobody seems to be helping the children with their Christmas play at church. But that changes over time as those new folks volunteer to help with the play and the music. Oh, I think I see Miss Mora. She's a single parent, raising her flock the best she can. You know, here in Stockwood, we've got our issues. We're just like the rest of the world, no different. Just different people from different places at different places of our lives. I'm just afraid that this Christmas, here in Stockwood, the real meaning of Christmas ain't front and center.
Come on, kids. Come on.
All right, kids. Now I want you to wait right here. All right? I got to go talk with this preacher. The church, it's our best hope. Now behave. Don't you move. Behave.
Well, Miss Mora, please come in. And the kids,
they can wait right here, preacher. I need to talk to you about some stuff out of their hearing.
All right, please come in.
Don't you move.
Children, you're looking mighty good today.
Hey, look!
to do something about those hippies first. They're just way too nice and probably up to something. I mean, they asked my children to be in their Christmas play.
Well, that's a good thing, right?
They fit at our church no time. They sing, they're always smiling. We don't need those types in Stockwood.
I'll do something about it. I promise you that, Miss Mora.
Well, since my husband, you know, I've been raising these kids according to the church, and I ain't gonna have this love and peace stuff brainwashing them. Now, come on, kids. Come on.
Merry Christmas.
Straight line.
See you, Snoop.
Hello, preacher. Look like you're still kicking it. Earl, get out of them flowers. Quit wallowing about.
Earl, get out of my flowers. Preacher, it's your youngins who caused this.
My youngins?
Earl, did an Aubrey boy do this to you?
My boy's in bed, I think.
Preacher, it's just like it's every time I come here, it makes me appreciate more and more where I live. I need a nap.
Howdy, preacher. Deacon, Lizbeth, y'all out mighty late.
Preacher, we got some church business we need to discuss.
Okay, we're alone here.
Now, I ain't one to complain, preacher. Lord knows I do what I think is best.
Yes, he does what's best. What is best?
Thank you, Lizbeth. Deacon, I'm listening.
We got two problems, preacher. We got two problems. The hippies are in town, and somebody invited them to church. And now, to beat it all, they're directing our Christmas play.
It's a sight.
Well, that would be me. I invited them, and I encouraged them. You and Miss Old Fogey asked that I do something about it. So, I did what you asked.
Preacher, say again.
In the friendly Christmas spirit, I invited the men. We didn't have volunteers to help the children with the Christmas play, so it only seemed natural.
So we asked, huh?
And I appreciate your prayers. It isn't every day that we can accept people and their differences. I mean, they're accepting of us, and I hear that the Christmas play is going to be, well, different in a good way this year.
Different? Well,
Brother Upton, I appreciate your leadership and your support, and with you, we've been able to add new people, and hopefully we can help Cecil Poole come to know our Savior.
Cecil Poole. Now, preacher, I don't know about that old stinking. Elizabeth, we got to go. Preacher,
Brother
it's good to see you.
Elizabeth, Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas.
Well, it's Christmas Eve night now. It appears that the folks from out of town that are being called the hippies have settled in. The church folks are wondering why things are staying the same, yet changing at the same time. It's a Christmas conundrum, I tell you, or puzzling, if you will. Folks here in Stockwood aren't looking at all the beauty and the differences of people, just like that quilt Miss Flo's are trying to make. Different colors, different textures and fabrics, all strung together with a common red thread. Like the blood of Christ, the baby we should be celebrating year-round. You know, I believe fans here at Stockwood are about to get a little more interesting. Hello, boys.
Hi.
Hi. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
I ain't gonna be in no hippies Christmas play. I ain't gonna do it.
Me either. Can't sing anyhow. Dad said it's awful having hippies in the choir loft.
I can't sing either.
Hello, boys. I couldn't help but overhear you.
Hey.
So, you don't like me?
No, didn't say that.
You called me a hippie. That's a label you've put on me. But this is how people dress in 1969, isn't it?
Yeah, but this is 2009.
What?
Great. Daddy-O got it wrong again. We're supposed to be in 1969. This is Woodstock, right?
No, this is Stockwood. Stockwood. You got it backwards, I'm thinking.
Bummer. Wrong place, wrong time. I was wondering about your crazy threads anyway. Listen, I need you dudes to help with the Christmas play. Sing a bit. It'll be far out. I know you can do it. You, sing any song that comes to mind. You are so cute.
He don't sing. Me and him don't sing. Hurry.
Shut up.
Those boys. Rather impressive.
I don't know.
You know why the community's struggling, don't you?
Dark scene. Heavy.
But people have loss, sadness, and predicaments, right?
Sure. The blood of our children is all around.
But it's Christ that came into the world to give us help over sin. And it's the spilled blood of the children. It's so precious. And it's sin that came into the world and causes the bad stuff. The children need to be reminded of Christ, of Christmas, right?
So you say.
But my husband and my daughter, Sammy, they've been confounded by the loss of this child. And Mr. Poole, how need to remind him that it's the story of Christ's birth, of Christmas. I know it. We just have to tell, right?
Uh-huh.
You are so wise to be so young. I've got to tell Q about you. Q? You, young lady, where'd she go?
Well, I could have filled you in on all that. It's righteous, out of sight, man.
Miss old fogey, you're a lingo.
Don't flip your wig, Square. Hang loose, Mama. These folks have taught me a few things about quilting. Jesus said, come follow me, and I will make you fishes of men. But not just those like you, but those different from you. Because, honey, we are all different. And this year, I'm using a red thread to bind the quilt together, like Jesus' blood binds all of us together. Get it? Get it?
Guys, come on! We're coming! Hurry up, slowpokes!
I want to be in the play, but...
But Mama's not so happy about it.
So?
I want Mama happy!
It's just this. Our story is just a footnote to the story. So let's go be a part of the story, what you say?
Huddle up, huddle up!
I really think we should do it.
Yeah, I agree.
We should do it no matter what Mom says. We can stand up to her.
This will never work.
But if it does, everyone can be happy.
Christmas, chick. Merry Christmas. Are you hip to Christmas, chick? You know that Jesus was born in a manger, the Savior, Mary was his mother. Do you know that cool story? You're the preacher's daughter, right? You know that cool story, but have you forgotten it, huh? It's a drag not to remember the story, because it's true. It's a story of wonder and joy.
I know the story, but...
But nothing, you're okay then. You know the story. His childhood, his suffering for us on the cross, his resurrection. He defeated sin, defeated sadness, defeated death, defeated defeat. And this Christmas, you just gotta tell it. That'll make you feel better. Tell it, because the world needs it told. Later.
You the preacher's girl, huh?
Uh-huh.
Where about you going? You better get back in the house.
Why?
The world's dangerous. I'm Cecil Poole.
I know who you are.
You do? And ain't you scared?
No, and I don't care who you are. I'm running away.
Why? Because of my Rosalie? You're her friend.
It was my fault she came. My fault.
Oh, it was somebody's fault. Mine, I think. Here now, hush up that crying. That don't do no good. Can't go and cry on Christmas.
Lots of people cry on Christmas.
Okay, enough.
Where are you going, Mr. Poole?
I gotta leave this town. The people, the memories.
But you told me not to leave. How come you're running?
Different.
How different?
Just different.
Like how, Mr. Poole? Like how?
I don't know. Nothing here for me now.
We're here. The church.
The church? Since my Rosalie... Ain't nothing here. Not for me.
Rosalie said you were the best man in the world, that you knew everything. I guess she was wrong.
She said that?
At church.
I can't figure out what it is about the church. And the story's there. She tried to tell me. Her face lit up when she told them. I just didn't listen. Do you know why Christmas? I mean, I bought her gifts galore. But the story... That lit her up so. Do you know it?
I know the story she tried to tell you, Mr. Poole, and I want to tell it. I do.
She was his girl, he was her boyfriend. She'd be his wife, make him her husband. A surprise on the way, any day. One healthy little giggling, wiggling baby boy. The wise men came, three made their way to shower him with love as he lay in the hay. Shower him with love, love, love. Love, love, love. Love, love is all around. Not very much of his childhood was known. Kept his mother Mary worried, always out on his own. He met another Mary who, for a reasonable fee, less than reputable was known to be. But his heart was full of love, love, love. Love, love, love. Love, love. When Jesus Christ was nailed to this tree, he said, oh, daddy, oh, and see how it all soon will be. Came to shed a little light on this darkened scene. Said, I fear blood of my children all around. Blood of my children all around. Blood of my children coming down. So I'm told, and so the story goes, the people he knew were less than golden hearted gamblers and robbers, drinkers and jokers, also searchers like you and me. Like you and me. He was rumored to be, for his deviations, taken into custody by the authorities less informed than he. Drinkers and jokers, also searchers like you and me. Like you and me. Preparations were made for a celebration day. Hey. He said, drink this wine, think of it as me. Eat this bread and dream it will be the blood of our children all around, the love of our children all around, the love of our children. Father up above, why in all this hatred do you fill us up with love? Fill us up with love, love, yeah. Love, love, love. You can't buy me love, love, love. All we need is love, love. And the love of our children all around.
There's hope in this story. Little lady, I think I understand now. Even though there's sadness, darkness, anger in this world, the baby Jesus makes things new. But I can't step foot in that church. I just can't. I promised myself.
Well, wait right here. I'll be right back. Don't move. Now, Cecil Poole, you are going to freeze today. Here, wrap yourself up in this quilt. It's made from swatches of fabric from everybody around here. This quilt has meaning, Cecil Poole, but more meaning on this Christmas for you.
I'm okay.
Now you wrap up, you hear? That little girl said this play was going to be out here on the street instead of in the church, and I ain't going to see no one sick over it, leastways you.
But...
Now you hush up, Cecil. Try to be a nice man for a change. Oh, look, here they come.
In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken, and everyone went to his own town to register. Joseph was hip with it. He registered. He did. Joseph went to Bethlehem because he was from the house of David, and he took Mary with him. She was about to have a baby.
Hey, lady, do you have any room for us? We'll take anything. Dig it?
We have traveled so far, and we kind of need it right now. They needed a place to stay, and there was no room in the inn. Then they went to a small barn, fixed up a feeding trough, and that's where they laid the baby, right here in Bethlehem. You can lay the baby in the manger there and pay no mind to the animals. They are really calm tonight.
There were shepherds in the fields nearby. It was night and they were looking after their sheep. An angel of the Lord appeared and the glory of God was shown all around them.
We were scared. We were nervous wrecks. We're poor people, working people, and we got angels talking to us.
But an angel said to them, "Be cool, relax, do not be afraid, because I bring good news of great joy. It's for all people, you included." Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is Christ the Lord. Here is how you will know I'm telling you the truth. You will find him wrapped in pieces of cloth, lying in a feeding trough.
A manger?
A manger is a feeding trough. I knew that.
Awesome!
Suddenly a large group of angels appeared from heaven, praising God, and they said,
"Glory to the God in the highest, and on earth peace and goodwill toward men."
Shepherds said to one another,
"Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened like the Lord has told us to."
They were digging it now.
So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby. And yes, the baby Jesus was in a feeding trough, the manger, just like the angel had said.
Away in a
Jesus was born in Bethlehem, three cool Eastern guys came.
Yes, three cool Eastern guys came.
They came to find the King of the Jews.
They followed the star and placed above the child.
They did it to worship him.
Shine, shine, shine.
King Herod tried to get us to work for him, but that's a long story. Where Jesus was, they saw him with his mother Mary, and then they opened up their they bowed down and worshiped him, and then they opened up their treasures and presented him with gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. They were really groovy gifts, and all this took place in what God has said through the prophets.
And the virgin will be with child, and she will call him Emmanuel, which means
God with us.